another part is that there is a constant body movement if you have observed the character of Harshad Mehta, right? His either his thumb is moving or his fingers, or there are eyeballs constantly moving. There is a constant energy flowing from his body. It shows a lot of things, like his restlessness.
A very well-known face in the Gujarati theatres and films, Pratik Gandhi has also done Hindi and English language films. But it's his portrayal of stockbroker Harshad Mehta in Hansal Mehta's recent web series Scam 1992 that has made him a nationwide sensation. Social media is flooded with praises for his acting prowess. Pratik was juggling with two passions, acting and engineering, till he delivered a nationwide hit Wrong Side Raju, after which he plunged into acting full-time. The movie went on to win National Award for Best Gujarati Film. Pratik Gandhi's name was also included in the Limca Book of Records with his play Mohan's Masala for a monologue which he performed in three languages, English, Hindi, Gujarati, on the same day.
Let's officially start the interview. Hello everyone, this is Nafisa from Simply Body Talk, and I welcome you all to our series of Nonverbal Champion, where we invite several guests from their different walks of life to share with us how body language has helped them in their career. And today on our show, we have an amazing personality and a wonderful actor, Mr. Pratik Gandhi. Hi Pratik, it's a pleasure to have you on our show.
Hello, hi guys, hi everyone, thank you for having me.
You are a young, powerful and a dynamic actor. Our audience would love to know your journey into acting.
So my journey in this field of acting started in school when I stepped on stage for the first time. I was in third standard. I started participating in all these school competitions, whether it is elocution competition, dancing competition or theater competition. And ever since then, I guess theater is the place where I feel at home, where I feel so comfortable. The moment I'm on stage, I'm a different person. I can transform myself into different characters, and I love doing that. So, and I picked up theater at such an early age of my life that it has become my second nature now. So okay. if you know, anyone asks me, when did you decide to be an actor? I don't have an answer, because I guess that's how I have grown up.
Wow. And you have been doing like different types of roles. So what are the kind of roles which you usually enjoy playing, and has body language helped you in forming those kind of roles?
So body language, I guess, is an integral part of how actors talk to audience and how actors create those characters. I had created a lot of biopic characters on stage. This is for the first time in front of the screen that I did Scam 1992, Harshad Mehta story, where I created this biopic character of Harshad Mehta on screen. But theatre had given me so many opportunities where I did these kind of characters. And as I said, body language is very, very important for an actor, because on stage, you know, specifically where there are no gigs, there are no major changes that we can do in terms of graphics or, you know, any computer aided designing or anything that you can't use on stage. So what we have to do, transform ourselves with the minutest of the body detail. Like on stage, where I've been performing monologues from last 8 years of 2 hours monologues that I perform, where I am, performing a character of different age groups. So without changing my costume, without getting into any, you know, look and feel of it, I just have to create those characters with a certain changes of body language, like shoulder position or, you know, my body posture, my back, the facial expressions, your eye movement. All those things, the moment I change it, I can actually transform myself as 85-year-old man to, you know, a 25-year-old guy to even a 6-year-old kid. And make-belief is such an interesting world, you know, that they can actually believe that a 35-year-old man can become 5 years kid, or it can become 85-year-old man. But everything can happen only with the changes in the body language that we do.
I would be saying a word, and whatever comes to your mind, you just have to tell me without thinking. It has to be really fast, okay? Acting.
Life.
Camera.
Camera is, oh, it's a, oh, camera is an eye, actually.
Audience.
Audience is God.
Social media.
Is a tool.
Fashion.
Fashion. Yeah, okay, you require it.
Cinema.
Cinema is the strongest language in the world.
Work.
Work. Oh, yeah. Work is worship.
Pratik Gandhi.
Simple.
You love playing those varied kind of roles so much. Do you have some experience on, you know, how it went, or, you know, how was the experience at that moment where you were on the stage and you were shifting the roles from like day to day?
It's a phenomenal experience, and I really cherish all those plays that I've done. I would tell you the play called Hoon Chandrakant Bakshi, which is a monologue Gujarati's most celebrated literature writer.
Okay.
He had written 167 novels.
Wow.
And he's the most celebrated writer, a very, very egoist person. And the challenge was to portray his ego on stage in the most adorable way, that people should fall in love with that ego. Now, interesting, that's a very interesting brief for an actor, you know, because ego is such a negative connotation. Mm-hmm. We don't like ego, egoist people. But when I perform, so the brief is that audience should fall in love with this characteristic of a character.
True.
Yeah, that ego, what an ego. And that's how he used to talk. He was very arrogant, but he write fire on paper. He kept writing fire on paper for a longer time, and that's how he's remembered. So now when I was performing that character, from his early life till he died at the age of 73.
Okay.
And I'm talking about, yeah, when I was actually 30, 31 year old, I was playing this character. I started playing this character from his journey of his 20s to his early 70s. Within 2 hours, without any, once I enter on stage, there are no exits. I'm not changing anything.
Hmm.
I'm not putting any mustache, any beard, any wig, anything. Nothing is changing. It's just purely a body language that transforms the character. And audience would still feel that, okay, now he's old. He just recovered that heart attack. He just lost his wife. The mood changes. And the entire travel within 2 hours, that audience travels with me, you know, from his 20 years journey to his 73 year old journey. Now, this kind of a training is such an important part of any actor's life that you keep doing on stage. And stage is the only place where you get this kind of experience and experiments to do. That helped me creating Harshad Mehta in Scan. So there are a lot of people, you know, who are telling me that we can see the transformation from his early days, when they see that entire changeover in the last episode, last three episodes, right? So, though in the screen, on the screen, you know, there are a lot of help that we get as an actor. There is a bald patch which was put on. There are different specs. The clothes are different. The costumes are different. But still, everything is, you know, everything works only because of the body language. If I change my shoulder position, the minute change in the shoulder position can actually talk a lot about an actor, character, and his journey and his emotional graph that time. Then the dialogue. I might not say a line, but if I change the shoulder position, you will understand that what he's going through. And that's the challenge. That's an interesting thing for an actor to do.
And when you play a part in any movie, or, you know, when any part in your movie is finalized, you would need some preparations to get into that character, to get into that personality. How do you do that?
So first of all, see, the way I understand the character's graph in the script is I try to, you know, create his emotional journey and emotional graph.
Mm-hmm.
His emotional travel throughout the script. And the character that he is, his background, you know, what kind of a person that we are trying to portray. What are we trying to communicate to the audience through this character and his journey? That's how I understand. Then there are certain mannerisms that, you know, we work around. And I try to make it a part of myself and my body so that it doesn't look forced and it looks believable. So I want to create a character through which people should not see Pratik in it, but they should directly get connected to that character.
Your recent stint in Scam 1992, of course, which is a big hit right now, where you have played the famous Harshad Mehta. Your character is outstanding. Like, when even we were seeing the show, it was like we are not seeing Pratik Gandhi. We are seeing Harshad Mehta. So a lot of efforts must have gone into that. And how was it for you, like preparing everything and acting it out?
Oh, it's an interesting process. Every time, every character is a very, very interesting and an insightful process for me. Specifically for Harshad Mehta, I had to gain a lot of weight. I know I gained 18 kilo of weight on my body to get into that huge body frame, the face, double chin, that mustache, the hairstyle and everything. Also, gaining a lot of weight helped me because my breathing pattern changed. So the way I take a pause in between the lines changed. The way I sit, the way I walk, everything changed, and that helps me. And I wanted that change to come organically in my body so that nowhere it looks forced. Apart from that, there are a lot of characteristics that we worked on, like, his travel from confidence to overconfidence to arrogance to ego is the journey that I was looking at. And then his complete breakdown, where, he was so big in his mind also, that it was difficult for him to realize that, okay, now I am not in a position to manage anything. And the world has come, over me, and now I have to give in. So it's an internal fight is what, we were trying to portray. So these are the characteristics and things largely that we worked around. Of course, there were a lot of technicalities involved as far as the subject is concerned, because of the scam, those transactions, those financial jargons, financial processes and all that I need to learn.
And during that very show, was there any time where, a certain part of it was really very challenging and then you overcame it somehow?
As audience would say that, as like you also just mentioned, that it's effortless, that you could see that effortless characterization. So I guess to create that effortlessness, a lot of effort needs to be put in the beginning. So the effort is the same thing, right? That whatever change, because see, I had this idea of getting that smirk, one-sided smirk for the character, the way he would smile at people, with a lot of confidence and sometimes with arrogance. So that is a very, very small part of entire character and characteristic. But I had to do it in such a way that it becomes my body, and nobody would feel that ye bahut force lag raha hai. So I had to practice that at various places with various intensity. Another part is that there is a constant body movement if you have observed the character of Harshad Mehta, right? His either his thumb is moving or his fingers, or there are eyeballs constantly moving. There is a constant energy flowing from his body. It shows a lot of things, like his restlessness. There is a constant, race in his mind that he wants to chase the world. He wants to make it big constantly. Now, these are very subtle changes that you get in your body.
So you never wanted to appear settled, and that is why it was.
Are very certain, very, very subtle thing that we tried. And that's how I created this character.
Simply Body Talk works with movie directors to ensure that the perfect personality is carved out on screen for the important characters by paying minute attention to body language that matters.
Wow. And you have an official record of performing monologue in 3 different languages on the very same day. That must be really hard. So what experience do you have about it?
Oh, it's an interesting thing. That's another monologue which is called Mohan's Masala.
Yeah.
It's about young Mohandas Gandhi, who's coming on stage and, he is telling the audience that, why are you all talking about Mahatma and the father of nation? You should talk about me because I made him.
Okay.
I am the one who gave you Mahatma, and bloody nobody talks about me. So it's his journey, and so we started that play in Gujarati first because that's our first audience. Then we did one show in English, and then somebody had kept a very close friend of mine. He had kept these shows in Dubai once, and I don't know what miscommunication must have happened. He announced that show there in Hindi. And by that time, we did not have a Hindi script in hand. We were still working on it. And suddenly, somebody told me that you're performing it in Hindi. I didn't know. I said, I also don't know about it. I'm not performing in Hindi. Just in English and Gujarati right now. He said, no, the tickets are sold. It's a houseful show in Dubai. And I guess you guys are going in next 10 days. And that's how I checked on social media, where all these announcements were happening, tickets were sold. So then me and my director, we spoke and we said that there are only two options. Either we cancel the show or else we create it in Hindi now. So that pushed us to make the show in Hindi. That was my first Hindi show. Now, I guess 2016, 10th June 2016, where we got a date in Prithvi. Mm-hmm. And that's when we decided to do this experiment that let's put up three shows of this play in different languages. So morning 11:30 Gujarati, evening 4 o'clock Hindi, and late evening 7:30, 8 o'clock show in English on the same day. And it's a 2-hour monologue in each language. So we attempted that and we approached Limca Books of Record and they said that it has never happened. So they registered us in Limca Books. So now I hold a Limca Book record for this play.
Okay. And do you think language plays an important role when it comes to portraying a certain character, or is it more of body language? And could you share some examples?
And so it's both, actually. It's both. Mm-hmm. Because when I performed that one play in three languages in one day, there are very interesting insights that I learned. Which, see, each language would have its own grammar when it comes to writing the language or speaking the language or even understanding the language. Similarly, each language would have its own performing grammar. When you perform that language on stage or in front of the camera, because the meter is different. If I say the same line in Gujarati, the meter is different. The pause work has to be different. It will land differently for the audience. The moment I make the same joke or punch in Hindi, it is different. English would be different. So that understanding is very interesting for an actor to perform. True. And similarly, so language and body language, both these things help each other, and it should complement each other to create a character.
And you're both as an engineer and as an actor, and like this both are two different things, very different things. So how was that shift for you?
Oh, well, I would say it was never a shift for me in literal terms, because I am equally passionate about both the fields, and I have worked for a longer time simultaneously in both the fields. So I can manage two things together. I could manage these two things together merely out of passion. As far as the final selection is concerned, where I actually had to decide whether I should continue as an engineer for a long time now or should become a full-time actor. In 2016, after Wrong Side Raju, was released, my second Gujarati film, it got national award also. Now is the time where I started having opportunity losses at both the place. Because at one side, I was getting good offers from across the, places as an engineer. And here also, I was offered good roles in new films, new theatre projects were coming in. And now, both the field would require more of my time and energy. Now it wouldn't have worked for me to continue both these things together. So then at that time I had to decide. But then this decision was difficult for me to select between two passions. But then acting was, I guess, always there in my heart, and it's where my my heart lies. So I continued with that.
Do you enjoy doing cinema, acting more, or is it more towards theatre? Because you're like in both, right? You mentioned you have love for acting, but is it more towards the camera one or performing in a theatre?
See, both has its own merits. Both has different excitement for me as an actor. In one side, theatre gives you instant gratification because you are constantly communicating with the audience live. And that energy, that communication of energy is something that is magical. Theatre also, gives you chance to improve yourself every time that you perform the same character again and again. At the same time, on the other side, film helps you reach out to a larger set of audience. It suddenly puts you on national or international level also. The film as a medium has its own challenge, which is very exciting as an actor. So I guess there is no comparison between these two films. But yeah, I would agree that stage is my first love.
Wow. And any words which you would like to share with our audience as inspiration?
So as inspiration, I would say just keep it simple, and if your passion and if your passion is able to drive you, then there is nothing better than that. So just listen to your innermost feel, because that can guide you better than anything else in the world.
Thank you so much for your time. You're truly a non-verbal champion. So many insights, and it was so much fun interacting with you. Like, you just prepared, like you did not even check the questions, and you were like, yeah, you go ahead, I'm going to answer, and it was so fluent. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, guys. Thanks for having me.
Audience, if you like this interview, please do like, subscribe, and do comment, because here is your favorite actor Pratik Gandhi, and yeah, your favorite role Harshad Mehta.